We now will move to our next set of presentations. I'll first invite Mr. Don Andre once again to come to the stage wearing a slightly different hat than when you heard him earlier this morning. He will now be representing Vinnova, which is the research agency, innovation agency for Sweden. So Dan will give you some insights into the opportunities offered by Sweden for researchers from Thailand and Southeast Asia. Dan?
Yeah.
Where's the clicker? The right arrow.
Okay. Thank you. So I'm also very happy to be here today to represent Sweden and to talk a little bit about opportunities for you to go there. I have rather a large number of slides with a lot of information, so apologize for going through them quickly, but as they will be sent out later, hopefully they can be useful for you to go back to. Sweden is both large in size, but very small in terms of population. But we are also quite big in innovations, and we have some famous innovations during the years. And also, we are among the highest spending on research and development in the world. Number three here after Israel and Finland. And actually on public spending on research, we have the highest in the world. And this is exemplified with the increase also we have made in public funding of universities during the 10 last years, even when we had an economic crisis in Europe and all over the world. So research is really a high priority, as we see it more as an investment rather than a cost in Sweden. And luckily also we benefit from all research because we score also very high in global innovation ratings. And we are also fortunate to have the largest number of global companies per capita in the world. And hopefully you know some of them. When it comes to research and our priorities, we very much care for the freedom for the researchers. So bottom-up principle is the most important principle in Sweden, the same as the European Research Council has, supporting the best frontier research. Also, we support a lot young researchers' career, and also gender equality is very important in Sweden. Looking at some other areas in particular, social science and humanities are important. I would say also that our strengths are in particular in life science areas, manufacturing, engineering, materials, ICT and energy. And also we see the need really to cooperate not only inside Europe but also outside Europe. As I said at the beginning, we have succeeded in Europe to have also the European research area with free movement of knowledge. We now have to move on in a way to a global research area. We are also strong in building research infrastructures. Here you see one example which is under construction at the moment, the European Spallation Source, which is one of the largest installations in Europe now, with cooperation with many European countries. So, how do you get to Sweden? Well, I will tell you a little bit about some possibilities through governmental agencies like Vinnova, but the most opportunities are directly through universities and research institutes, and then we also heavily depend and use the EURAXESS portal in Sweden. So the first agency here I mentioned is Vinnova, which I also work for, which is the main agency supporting innovation in Sweden in all areas. And the most interesting program for you would be this Mobility for Growth. It's actually co-funded by the Marie Sklodowska Korea Action. So we have a national program co-funded by the European Commission. And it's also interesting here because you do not need to apply directly for a mobility grant to go to Sweden. You can also apply for a planning grant in advance, which makes it easier for you to take the next step. I have also in my slides here normally also indicated a person who you can contact for more information on practical aspects. The largest agency in Sweden funding research is the Swedish Research Council, and they are in a way very similar to the European Research Council, as they fund basically bottom-up research with excellence as the only criteria. And they have a number of schemes. One scheme is visiting professorships for quite short time, 6 months to maximum 1 year. The focus on areas in social science and humanities, and also in physics and some of the related areas. But also here it's a bit similar to the ERC Marie Curie. You can apply directly to project grants in Sweden. But you have to establish some contacts first with the Swedish university in the same way you have to do for the Marie Curie actions. And you can also get help of this with these contacts, of course. But the main opportunity is to apply directly for the grants. And you can find more information on this link here at the Swedish Research Council. I would also like to mention some activities which are carried out here in the region by the Swedish Development Agency, SIDA. They are covering the whole region, but they're actually based here in Bangkok at the Swedish Embassy. And they fund a number of different networks for capacity building, creation of new knowledge, and promotion of research, in order to contribute to sustainable development, for example. And this scheme might not get you to Sweden directly, but it could be a good way to start cooperation with Sweden to look into these networks. And you have a reference here to the different networks. And in this way, you could then maybe at a later stage also go to Sweden. So, as I said initially, most recruitments are done by universities directly, and we have quite a large number of universities being a small country. And we all encourage them to use EURAXESS to put all the available posts and vacancies, so we don't need to develop our own system in Sweden. And also then what is important, especially for you, is that most universities have a very good service to help you with practical issues. So these services exist at all universities. And also, as you might not have contact with particular universities, there is also an agreement that the contact points at the Gothenburg University, they will act as an entry point. So if you don't have any contacts, you can contact the Gothenburg entry point, and they will also help you to get in touch with other universities. And universities in Sweden, they all have also or facilitate individual academic career from postdoc and upwards, and of course they also facilitate mobility between industry and academia. Then I know from my experience also that when you move to a new country, it's not only the quality of research which is important, it's also the social side of your stay, and many of you also move with families. And here I'm happy to say that Sweden's social welfare systems welcomes you. Sweden has one of the most generous parental leave, for example, in the world, and also very affordable childcare services and generous sickness benefit and rehabilitation allowances. This might not be the picture you're looking for going to Sweden to be on parental leave, but it's just to say that the possibility is there for everyone to be on parental leave, and it's the same opportunities for the mothers and fathers to be on parental leave. So I can't give you maybe one telephone number to call to Sweden, but I'm happy at least to give you one email address because we have a national contact point for EURAXESS in Sweden at Vinnova, and she is more than happy to assist you with general questions and guide you also where you can find contacts in Sweden. And of course, I'm also happy to guide you and help you, and I will also be here during the day today. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dan. We have a little time for a few questions, if someone has any urgent questions. There's someone over there.
Thank you very much for your information. My name is Namrata Paulson from National Materials and Metal Technology Center. I wonder what is exactly the Vinnova function? Are you an like funding agency, or are you just matching up the researcher and host, and the host can only be university or also a private sector? Thank you.
Vinnova is the main agency for funding of research innovation in Sweden. So they fund both companies and universities. The important thing is the impact of the research. We put more requirements on the impact, for example, than the Swedish Research Council. But both universities and research institutes and companies are funded. So they have we have a budget about 300 million euros per year. So it's also the possibility to apply for grant at Vinnova in the same way as for the Swedish Research Council. In addition, Vinnova, I highlighted this scheme of mobility grant because it is in particular relevant for you to get to Sweden, but there are also a lot of activities. I have some information outside about the agency there.
Any more questions? Thank you so much, Mr. Andre. Mr. Andre will be around, of course, for part of the event today, so you can approach him later during lunch.